Hi there. If you're a Dutch guy or woman, then you're probably pretty disgusted with the new agreement. Not because we're gonna ban burqas and we're gonna kind of require clerics of mosques to be moderate, if they want to become a Dutch citizen at least. But because we're basically not doing our job at all as a government. You know, we're looking at the economical factors, which are completely artificial in the current banking environment. We don't know what the shadow banking system holds. We don't know what the currency wars will result in. We don't know, which banks are solvent or not. But we allow them their reasoning to guide us into a future in which we're basically killing ourselves. It's completely clear. We're gonna get nuclear power plants, two more. We're gonna get coal-fired power plants. We're gonna get carbon capture and storage, which is all complete and utter screaming nonsense, which is all only meant to allow the energy cartel to continue its dominance. It's disgusting. I'm really disgusted because you have people that know about these things, and they figure out and they tell us that the way that we are going is going to become a huge catastrophe for Europe. You have different skills of reasoning about it. One is that we get mass migrations because people at the Mediterranean region cannot grow any food anymore, so they'll come over to Holland, and we're not able to protect ourselves, we know that for sure. On a larger scale, we are killing the oceans. The UN says we have 40 years of life in the oceans, and then fish will be gone. There will be an acidic pool of death. And the third one is third level, or the highest level, and I guess the most, it's not unreal, simply people are just finding evidence, like this is what happens if you have catastrophic climate warming, which means is all species go extinct. There's nice words for it: deluge, cataclysm, mass extinction, evolutionary reset. That means all humans will also perish, most of them at least. I guess a few might be left, in some capsule somewhere, and it won't be 20,000 years or 24,000 years, it will be 500,000 years before you get new life forms of any size, before you get rid of the sulfur hydrogen atmosphere that nobody can breathe, because it's the primordial, it's the pre-life atmosphere, it's the atmosphere we had before life basically came about on Earth. So thanks. Yes, and then it's very wise to promote air traffic, to promote sea traffic, to promote road traffic, to promote coal-fired power plants, to promote economical expansion, all those things. It's really wise to do that. You're completely insane as a politician. You're completely brainwashed, and you completely lost your mind if you think that you're a leader of any stature with such a policy. I really don't understand why, or I really actually do understand. It's simply the trinket mindset in a negative form. You have, of course, people like to have shiny things, but they also like things to be neat. So if they can't be shiny, then at least let's let them be organized. We'll simply all die in a very neat country. We all, let's say, be facing all kinds of trouble with our food supply, and be inundated, and be breathing the toxic fumes that are coming from the sea at a certain point, in a very neat environment. And it's just, I'm completely disgusted by it. But you can be. It's just, I can't even be positive about the social aspects of this agreement, because they are not that bad. We are not doing austerity very much. Of course, we don't have to, because we're gonna, explore the oil in Brazil, and we're gonna have these nuclear power plants. So, we're just a hub for Germany. We're doing fine economically, I guess. We're actually gonna have 1.5% growth next year, economical growth. Fantastic. That's like being happy that you find a cigarette in your pocket while you're in an airplane that's clearly crashing. It's just dumb, stupid fucking country.